I just had 3 cups of coffee and sugar for breakfast and my hands are shaking. Let's get this bread. Okay, so tryptophan. Tryptophan is nonpolar, it's hydrophobic, and it's aromatic because it's got these rings. In fact, this side chain is composed of 2 rings and it's called an indole. It's an essential amino acid, which means we can't synthesize it in our body and we need to obtain it from our diet. And because of its chonky side chain, it's actually used in membrane protein as a way for the protein to anchor themselves within the lipid bilayer. Tryptophan is also used as an antidepressant in some drugs. Next, tryptophan is actually also used as a fluorescent probe in research sometimes because it glows when it's excited because of its aromatic rings. Tryptophan is also the precursor for several neurotransmitters such as serotonin and melatonin, melatonin being the one I miss out on at night. It also is the precursor for vitamin B3, otherwise known as niacin. This vitamin helps with metabolism, and auxins, which are plant hormones that help the plant grow towards where the light source is so the plant can grow taller. Okay, so you know how I said there are 20 amino acids, right? Well, that only means 20 main amino acids. There's always derivatives of the 20 main amino acids and other ones that are used in proteins, but they're not as common, so they're not counted in the 20 main amino acids. Well, tryptophan has a cousin, and this cousin is 5-hydroxytryptophan, otherwise known as oxytryptin. This is how tryptophan becomes serotonin, which is a neurotransmitter that makes you happy, and that's why tryptophan is used as an antidepressant sometimes, because it leads to serotonin. Same with oxytryptin. An enzyme adds a hydroxyl group right here to tryptophan, and it becomes 5-hydroxytryptophan, which means the hydroxyl group is on the 5th carbon, and it's on a tryptophan. Finally, for serotonin, an enzyme removes the carboxyl group from 5-hydroxytryptophan, and it becomes serotonin, which makes you happy. And finally, there's this condition where if you have too much tryptophan, it results in eosinophilia meiaglia. This is a white blood cell. And meiaglia actually means muscle pain. So that kind of gives you an idea of what the disease could mean. Eosinophilia means there's an overabundance of white blood cells in your body, and that can cause flu-like symptoms, and you also get muscle pain, which meiaglia refers to. So yeah, that's tryptophan. Bye!